Hey everyone, welcome to Remain Wild. My name is Rick Evans. I'm a wildlife photographer. Today we are going to be going over some very exciting updates to Adobe Lightroom. If you've seen these and played with them, you've probably seen how amazing it is already. If you haven't, stick around. I'm going to show you some pretty cool stuff. The most notable change is the new masking tools, and that's pretty much what I'm going to go over today. Why don't we just move right into Lightroom and I'll show you how it's all set up and how it all works. Now, one of the things you might notice when you first open this up is, what happened to my toolbar? Where's my tools? Well, they're all still here. They've just been kind of rearranged. Don't freak out. I'll show you where they are. So, like graduated filters and radial filters, they're under this new masking section here. So when we click on this, what we're gonna do is it opens up this little box here. And I've already made some adjustments to this photo just where I would normally do it before I start applying other masks and things like that. So these were already here. But I'm just gonna show you guys how some of this other stuff works. And I'm looking at this for the first time, so this should be pretty neat. So we're gonna do create new mask and select subject and select sky. These are the new ones that they've just added. And this is what I'm talking about. I have not seen how these work yet, so I'm pretty excited. Your brush tool, your gradient tool, and your radial filter are all still right here. Okay, so if you want to apply one of those, you just click that and it works just the way it used to. And then you can also do a color mask or luminance mask down here, and those work the same way they always did. But let's try the subject mask. This is like, so essentially what it should do is, let's just click it. All right, new mask. Detecting subject, right? Oh my God, look at that. That is amazing. It literally, now this was kind of like a sort of a busy background, right? But look, I mean, that is incredible. Now, some of you guys might be saying, well, Photoshop has always had this, but Lightroom hasn't, okay? So this is really powerful tools that they've now added into Lightroom, so you don't have to drag them into Photoshop to do all this stuff separately and just make the workflow a little bit more complicated. Now, this is very Photoshop-y. It's almost like, not layers, but it's showing me each mask here. So if I hover over them, it shows me where each one is. But that did a perfect job. There's a little bit here on the wing where it kind of went over, and there's a little bit here where it kind of went a little into the sky, but other than that, it cut that bird out perfectly. So here's how this works. So now I can make adjustments to just that selection. Look at that. So if I wanted to like warm him up a little bit, cool him down a little bit, or maybe like lift the shadows on him and like drop the noise on him a little bit. Cool. Now can I do, okay, so there is an invert option. So let's do that same thing, but this time let's try this. Create a new one. Let's do, all right, so invert. Wow, holy crap, this is amazing. Now look, I can drop the entire background, bring it all the way up. This is incredible. Now that background's kind of noisy, so what I'm gonna do is actually drop some of the texture on it, just a little bit, and then do some noise reduction on it. And let's shift the color of it a little bit. Make it cooler. Bring up the whites, bring up the saturation, bring down the shadows. And it's only adjusting the background. That is incredible. Look at this. Look at that. Wow. 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 That's fun. Okay, I'm sold. I like it. So that's that's how that works. Now, I noticed when I made a new mask, let's just do another one. I just want to check something here. It automatically applies the overlay, the color overlay here. And I noticed that there's a little box down here. Now, if I hit O, I can toggle that on and off. Okay, so if that's annoying to you, but I like that it pops up just to let me know that it did something, that it applied, like where it applied that filter. Oh, I know what I want to check. Let's see here. Can I delete this? Let's just, all right, delete that one. Now, this one, because it sort of went over a little bit, let's see something here. How do I don't have my, I didn't use a brush, so how can I subtract that? What are these? Oh, there we go. So if you click on it, you get some more options. Let's see, subtract. There we go. Let's use the brush. I want to see the overlay. Make it a little bit bigger. Oh yeah, there we go. Look at that. Wow. Paint that out, and then there's a little, it kind of went a little in this wing here, so I'm gonna get rid of that. Oops. Now that's obviously a little nitpicky, but I just wanted to see if I could, remove some of the masking where I didn't want it to be, and that's how you would do that. Pretty easy, you can do add and subtract, and it looked like they gave you options to, you could use like the grad filter or the radiant filter to do the same thing as opposed to the brush, so that's kind of cool. Okay, cool. Let's do another photo here, what do you say? So this one has a lot of sky in it, so why don't we try to see if it can find the sky. Select sky. Did it grab the, looked like it kind of grabbed the bird too, right? Let's see. Oh no, it didn't. Wow. Wow. Look at that. Holy crap. Guys, this is, you know, there's a part of me that kind of is like, well, this kind of takes some of the work out of the, out of, you know, editing the photos. But guys, the creative control that they have now given you using these tools is phenomenal. Like I just, the amount of work that it used to take to make these masks and do this stuff wasn't intense, but definitely not this easy. This is by far the biggest, coolest update that I've seen to Lightroom since I started using it. Okay, let's move on to another one. Now again, I've already done a lot of work on this one, as you can see. Now this was from actually a previous version. This was before the update. So all these masks were applied before I updated Lightroom. But let's just do, oops, what am I doing? Like subject. Now this one again, this should be pretty easy to find because it's a pretty clean background. But some of it's kind of dark, so I'm curious to see if it grabs this beak against the dark background. Oh no, it figured it out. Look at that. Now let's clean this up. I'm just kind of being rough here. I'm not, getting too precise. It's a little sloppy, but you guys get the idea. So now, okay, so that's that one. That seems pretty easy. Now this one I grabbed because it's got a little bit more going on. Oh, look at this, these little tags where all of our filters are. Kind of like, instead of those little gray dots we used to have, I didn't even notice that in the previous ones. That's kind of cool. This one I picked because the background is a little bit more busy, okay? Now again, these were applied in the previous version of Lightroom, not during this, so I wanna see how well it does at grabbing the subject on a busier background, right? Because he kind of blends in here. So let's just see. Because obviously, like against a clean background, like the last two that I just did, it's pretty easy to determine the subject. But whoa, it didn't grab anything it wasn't supposed to there. Look, it didn't even grab the branch or anything. Lightroom knows what a bird is. Look at that. That is freaking amazing. Wow. Look at that. I hope you guys can really appreciate this. Those of you who've been using Lightroom for a while and used to have to drag your photos into Photoshop to do all this heavy masking, you could have done some of this in Lightroom before, but this, just the how easy it is, how just quick it grabs it, you're not having to do any extra work, you're not painting in anything. this is just really, really smart. And I'm Adobe, I'm blown away. Now this one, this one's kind of a cool one. Let's have fun with this one here. Select subject. There's our guy. Did it grab anything it wasn't supposed to? Nope. All right, and let's bring down the blacks, bring up the whites. Let's add a little bit of texture. And then let's do another one. Let's do the invert. Oh, that looks a little different, huh? That still works the same. It's our old friend, the radial filter here. Invert. Exposure. Feather that a little bit more. Now, can I, yeah, look at that. I can rename this. So if I was like, bird, BG. For background, and then this one, light ray. This is cool. This is fun, man. This is Adobe. Yes, yes, I like this. I'm for it. Now, guys, this isn't anything, I just want to reiterate, this really isn't anything that wasn't in Lightroom before. Like, you kind of had all this control in Lightroom previous to this. They've just made it easier to get to these selections and manipulate them. I think they've just really streamlined the whole process and made it a little bit more accessible for people who aren't familiar with this type of masking and selection of the photo, so you can really manipulate very fine details. So I'm gonna keep playing with these tools because it's just a lot of fun and I wanna learn them just in depth so I can bring more videos to you guys. If you did get information out of this video and you liked it, toss me a like, hit subscribe so that you know when I've got new Lightroom videos coming out. I've got some new tech videos, camera reviews. I'm actually recording this video on two new cameras, this one and this one, that I have yet to release yet, but reviews are coming for them. This is the new Sony ZV-E10, and this is the new DJI Action 2. So stay tuned for reviews of both of those cameras. Make sure you're subscribed, because I got lots of wildlife stuff going on, camera reviews, all kinds of fun stuff. I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for stopping by. Take care.